They're trying the weapons every day. Not in labs, down there on the field. They're trying their weapons. I was trying their weapons in Bil'in, in Yalin, in Kfar Kadum, in Abi Salah, in Bethlehem, in Hebron, El Halil, South Man Hebron, in East Jerusalem. We're trying the weapons every day, and then we're selling it outside. And I couldn't believe the things that I'm seeing, so I'm going deeper and deeper. And then I realized that, you remember this guy, the young guys that threw stones in the beginning of the protest? They were not Palestinians. They were actually an undercover unit of the Israeli army looking like me, Arab Jews, disguising as Palestinian inside these villages, starting a riot, starting something, so the Israeli army will have a good excuse to start shooting the place up. That the Israeli government and the Israeli army is trading weapons with, trading knowledge with, trading technology, or training their soldier by themselves in those countries. In the last 40 years, we were involved in the worst dictatorships and regimes in the world. And we are making a killing out of it, literally. We're making so much money out of it. And then I understand, this is not an occupation, it's a laboratory. Sometimes as a soldier, I would infuse poison to Palestinians. Sometimes as a protester, I will run away with Palestinians and be in a lab rat. But all this time, we're trying weapons out and selling them out there. In the source of everything, it's not the religion, it's not the land, there's a lot of money. Two and a half months ago, we were on the Maryland Highway on our way to do this kind of lectures in Washington, D.C. And we were on our way, we crashed our car in the middle of the Maryland Highway. When we were stuck in the middle of the highway, people were driving next to us, and we did something we don't really like to do, we called the police. And the police came very fast, very efficient. The Maryland officer police came and took us out of the highway. Tall car came and took my and another friend with our car to the lot, and I got a ride along with the Maryland officer police. And for 10 minutes, we're driving silently, and I have no idea it's gonna change my life, this ride. And we're driving quietly, and then the guy is looking at me, the officer of the Maryland police is looking at me and saying, so, where are you from? And I'm saying, oh, I'm from Israel. And the officer is saying, oh, man, you guys are bad asses. You know how to silence the one that opposes you. You know how to calm them down. Nobody disobey you. You guys are the best. And I'm saying, whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't think you really know a lot about the Israeli army, so, you know, never mind. He's saying, oh, no, no. I just came back from there. I'm saying, what, is a tourist? I'm saying, no, with the Maryland police. We just came back from training with your military and your police. I'm saying, what? Saying, oh yeah, you know, all of our police here in the US is going to a few weeks to Israel and trained with your army and your police. Oh yeah, you know, all of our police here in the US is going to a few weeks to Israel and trained with your army and your police. And I'm starting investigating more and more, getting more information out there. And then before I leave the house, his car to the lot, I'm thinking, is there a chance you know Shlomo Efrati, my father, the head of investigation of the Jerusalem police? And the guy takes out his cell phone and flipping pictures, and he got a picture hugged with my dad in the middle of the night in Washington, D.C. And I'm just blown away. I'm going out of the car, and I'm calling my dad in Jerusalem, and I'm saying, Dad, what the hell? And my dad is telling me, oh, come on, Irani, don't be naive. You know NYPD got an office in Tel Aviv, right? You know NYPD got an office in Tel Aviv, right? You know we got an office in New York, right? Come on, we're working together to protect you. But you guys should know, you are next in line. The next one who will die from a tear gas canister into his chest. We'll be in Zuccotti Park, we'll be in Denver, we'll be in Oakland, in San Francisco. It is happening here already. It's happening to different people, to people of color, to immigrants in this country. It's already happening. You guys are next in line. The next one will die out of brutality of the police will be one of your sons or your daughters in a protest, because they're training together. Your police training with our army. Our army is training them how to take care of the enemy, because Palestinians are our enemy. But when they're coming back, you are their enemy. All this time, when we are taking care of our communities, I was taking care of mine and you were trying to take care of yours, they, the government, the police, they were organizing together globally to oppress us.
Listening to the hard times of a dangerous mind born under a bad sign. I never had much, never bothered to ask why. When they cashed the chips out, I probably was passed by. I never was baptized, forever been chastised. The company I kept in every one of my past lives is misery, that's each and every one of my past wives. Heavy habit of rocking the boat to the capsize and telling these black lies, hoping I don't backslide. Succumbing to the shadow that I'm being attacked by. They trying to sidetrack me, yo, the odds are stacked high. It's shaking me and breaking me and making me that guy. To act like I'm kind of unable to act right and snap like a crack fiend, craving a crack pipe, a bad dream. Everything lit under the black light. Confessions of a black man living a fast life.
Da-da-da.